morning, everybody. My name is Steven Generally, and I will be your teacher on puberty. Okay, but before we begin that, I want you fourth graders to take one of these. Now, if you would please come to the front and put it into the water. This water represents the stage of puberty, where those little kids turn into these adults. So, just drop it in. No, don't take it off. Just drop it in. So, thank you. You may retain these. Okay. Now, for those of you who do not know what puberty is the stage when you mentally and physically change from a child to an adult. So, as I was saying earlier, this is our puberty, and these things, testosterone and estrogen, are very two important hormones that you will hear about later. Okay, later here. So, testosterone is what is in the male body. It what helps us turn into men. And estrogen is the female's hormone that helps you turn into woman. Now, I'm not going to go too deep into the single sex it's physical traits, but I will describe the traits that we all go through. Most of the changes, I will go through all of them. Let us start with emotional changes. So emotional changes can include mood swings, when one moment you're happy and then out of the blue you're sad or mad or angry at whatever. And then sometimes, and you also get a little bit more irritable, so you get angry at things quicker, easier. Like let's say someone didn't sharpen your pencil to the right length, like go back and sharpen it. This isn't sharp enough. You get angry at them. Also, the brain is developing, so you start thinking. You think about what it would be to be in an adult situation. You got into a car accident. What would you do? You start thinking about those kind of things. You also start arguing with your parents. You think you're all grown up. So, continue on to our physical changes. Physical changes include pimples, which are caused by sebaceous glands, which help produce the oils that keep your skin young and shiny. But during your puberty years, it overproduces and gets into your pores, and when dirt or particles like that meet the oil, they form pimples. Now, the best way to prevent these are, number one, do not eat a lot of sweet stuff. Your body already has enough sugars in it, and it does not need more. Number two, wash your face often. Washing every day will help get rid of some of that dirt, which will help reduce the risk of getting a pimple. And number three, if you do get a pimple, do not, and I mean do not, pop it. Popping pimples can lead to sores, scars, and more pimples. Next up, we have body odor. Body odor gets quite common during puberty. The sweat glands, they're overproducing, so when you go outside, you get sweaty more often. So you might have to shower twice a day, morning, evening, and then you might also have to start using deodorant every day or once or twice a week. Next up, we have growth spurts. The growth spurts are when you get taller, so maybe you might start eating more often. Sometimes you grow 4 inches in 1 year.